హే గాయ్స్, దిస్ ఈజ్ వీకే, అంటే వంశీ కృష్ణ. పేరు మీకు తెలిసిందైనా నేను మీకు ప్రజెంట్ చేయాలనుకునే కంటెంట్ మాత్రం ఖచ్చితంగా మీకు తెలియదు. సో పాయింట్ ఏంటంటే, ఒకరోజు అలా ఇన్స్టాగ్రామ్ స్క్రాల్ చేస్తూ ఉంటే తెలియకుండా నాకు వచ్చిన ఆలోచనే నా ఈ పాడ్కాస్ట్. ఎంతోమందిని మనం ఫాలో చేస్తాం, ఇంకెంతోమంది పోస్ట్కి లైక్ కొడతాం, మరీ నచ్చితే స్టేటస్లో పెడతాం. అలా మనం లైక్ చేసిన వాళ్ళ గురించి ఎప్పుడైనా మీకు తెలుసుకుందాం అనిపించిందా? అరే, వీళ్ళు చేసే కంటెంట్ బాగుంది, వాళ్ళు చేసే ఆర్ట్స్ బాగున్నాయని మీకు ఎప్పుడైనా అనిపించిందా? అలా నాకు అనిపించిన ప్రతి టాలెంటెడ్ ఇండివిజువల్ ఇన్సైట్స్ని ట్యాప్ చేసి మీ ముందుకు తీసుకురావాలని డిసైడ్ అయిపోయింది. మన మధ్యలోనే ఉన్న వాళ్ళ టాలెంట్స్ని, ఐడియాస్ని అందరికీ తెలిసేలా చేయడమే ద మెయిన్ థీమ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ పాడ్కాస్ట్.
హే గాయ్స్, దిస్ ఈజ్ వీకే. వెల్కమ్ టు మై 14th ఎపిసోడ్ ఆఫ్ తెలుగులో పాడ్కాస్ట్ ఇన్ కొలాబరేషన్ విత్ బ్యూటీ మీడియా. సో ఈ వీక్ వచ్చేసి మనకి ఇంకొక డిఫరెంట్ టాలెంట్తో మీ ముందుకు వచ్చేసాను. తన ఎవరంటే, ఈజ్ ఎ బీట్ బాక్సర్, నాట్ ఎ నార్మల్ బీట్ బాక్సర్. ఈజ్ ఇండియాస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ కజూ బీట్ బాక్సర్ ఆర్టిస్ట్. సో తన పేరు వచ్చేసి హరిహరన్, ఆల్సో పాపులర్లీ నోన్ యాజ్ హ్యారీ డి క్రూజ్. సో ఇంట్రడ్యూసింగ్ మై దిస్ వీక్స్ గెస్ట్ హ్యారీ. హాయ్ హ్యారీ, ఎలా ఉన్నారు?
హాయ్, ఐఎమ్ సో గుడ్, హౌ యూ డూయింగ్ టుడే?
బాగానే ఉన్నాను. సో ఫస్ట్లీ ఇట్స్ వెరీ ప్లెజర్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్ టు హ్యావ్ యూ యాజ్ మై గెస్ట్. థ్యాంక్స్ ఫర్ కమింగ్ ఎట్ ద షార్టెస్ట్ ఇన్వైట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ గివెన్ టు యూ.
But also, I should also thank you so much for giving me an invite and representing or presenting my art in your platform is really one of the appreciable one that I can say from my end. And thank you so much.
So basically, ఇప్పుడు ఒకవేళ మన ఆడియన్స్కి ఒకవేళ మీ గురించి తెలియకపోతే, ఫస్ట్ మీ ఇంటరాక్షన్ నుంచి స్టార్ట్ చేద్దాం. సో మీ బేసిక్ ఎడ్యుకేషనల్ బ్యాక్గ్రౌండ్ ఎక్కడి నుంచి వచ్చింది, ఇప్పుడు మీరు ఏం చేస్తున్నారు దాకా మీరు ఇంట్రడక్షన్ ఇవ్వగలరా లిజనర్స్ కోసం?
స్కూల్ వచ్చి ఇంద్రానగర్ హై స్కూల్ని చదివినా. ఓకేనా, అంతవరకు పియూసీ, ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ మై ప్రీ యూనివర్సిటీ అట్ ఇంద్రానగర్ కాంపోజిట్ పియూ కాలేజ్. అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ ఐ హావ్ ఎంటర్డ్ మై గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ పార్ట్, విచ్ వాస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది డ్రాస్టికల్ డ్రమాటిక్ థింగ్స్ ఆల్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇన్ మై గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ థింగ్, వేర్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ డిఫికల్ట్ పార్ట్స్. సో వెన్ ఐ సే గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్, ఐ డిడ్ మై బీకామ్ బ్యాచులర్ ఆఫ్ కామర్స్ అట్ ఇండియన్ అకాడమీ డిగ్రీ కాలేజ్. And currently I'm like pursuing my master's, master of business administration in St. George College of Management Studies. I'm also working, but as well as going to regular college at times. Since it's a COVID situation here, we have, it's all online classes that is taking places.
Okay. So listeners, ఈ ఎపిసోడ్లో ఒకవేళ మేము కొంచెం ఇంగ్లీష్ ఎక్కువ మాట్లాడితే లైట్ తీసుకోండి, ఎందుకంటే హీ హ్యాడ్ సమ్ డిఫికల్టీ ఇన్ స్పీకింగ్ ఫ్లూయెంట్ తెలుగు. Because of the lot of moving places around. So please excuse us for this episode if we speak less Telugu. So Harry, how did you come across this beatboxing talent and how did you make it as India's first kazoo? First explain what is kazoo.
Okay, kazoo ante oka instrument adu. Chena oka American instrument, chikku tarvata oka wind instrument ara untundi. Adanna, I was like, many people were there, beatboxers means many would be there. So whenever we go to parties, whenever we go to any college cultural fest or something like that, anywhere we go, there were a bunch of beatboxers and I just wanted to be a part. I mean, I just wanted to be outside the box. Like I have to be unique to give me any opportunities. If I have to go to any performances, stages or something, I need some recognition or anything unique from the other beatboxers. So okay. I found this instrument called kazoo on YouTube channels. So beatboxing is something to do with vocal, which we use our mouth and throats and produce things, right? So beatboxing can match up with wind instruments. Like we can play it with flute, harmonica, and the saxophone, or something like that, we can use it. And over there, I found this instrument and I tried it. So then after what happened, in the month of 2018 or 2019, I'm really not sure, I have done a video wishing everybody a Merry Christmas video and I have sent it to record claiming for recording that I'm one of the first person, because I should research about it, right? On YouTube I went because there were Americans doing it, all the foreign people artists were doing with kazoo, but nobody did it with India and claiming themselves and things like that. So I just sent a video to them and after like 2-4 months after a long verification process, Parents Book of World Record have given me the title as India's first kazoo beatboxer using the video. and that's how I got the record. And also I'm one of the person who can produce the finest saxophone sound with the use of human voice. This how I recognized is because there were beatboxers, but many used to ask me or wanted to learn from me the saxophone sound, how we do it.
Okay.
I never used to teach them because that's something which is unique in me. If I teach
USP.
Them,
yeah.
So I was selfish in that part. But I used to teach beatbox
fair
and
enough.
Part and fair, but it's okay.
Okay. So ippudaka mee journey ela undi, ee beatboxing journey, are you enjoying it as a occasional part time gig or you want to do this as a as your mainstream career?
See, building up a career in India as an artist, as a beatboxer, is damn difficult, because as an artist it's very difficult to survive, first of all. So I it's just my passion. I just want to take it as a passion. I would love to perform on stage and entertain people, but at the same time, for bread and butter, beatboxing cannot give me wholesome amount. It's just like a pocket money I can get. If in case if you get an opportunity to perform or to get into reality shows, maybe a situation can change. But as of now, I'm saying that we have to obviously look for an alternative job or work in a corporate company and just look after beatboxing as a passion whenever we get time or whenever we get our schedule our time accordingly, give our time to beatboxing and entertain people. And that's how I'm doing it after my graduation part.
Okay, super. అసలు ఈ ఫస్ట్ టైం ఇండియాలో అసలు బీట్ బాక్సర్సే చాలా తక్కువ మంది ఉన్నారు, చాలా తక్కువ అవేర్నెస్ ఉంది దాని మీద. రీసెంట్లీ గల్లీ బాయ్ నుంచి ఇంకొంచెం అవేర్నెస్ స్టార్ట్ అయింది హిప్ హాప్ కల్చర్ మీద. సో బిఫోర్ దాట్ అసలు బీట్ బాక్సింగ్ అనేది మీరు ఫస్ట్ టైం మీ లైఫ్ లో ఎప్పుడు విన్నారు, అండ్ హౌ డిడ్ యూ ద ఫ్యాసినేషన్ స్టార్టెడ్ ఇన్ యూ టు స్టార్ట్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ దిస్?
సో వెన్ ఐ వాస్ డూయింగ్ మై ప్రీ యూనివర్సిటీ కదా, అప్పుడు నా కాలేజ్ లో ఒక సీనియర్ అమ్మాయి ఉండాలి. వాడు ఏం చెప్తున్నారు, కాలేజ్ ఫెస్ట్ వాస్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్, నాకు ఏమి ఇంట్రెస్ట్ లేదు, అదని అటెండ్ చేయాలి, అటెండ్ చేయకూడదు, నాకు ఇంట్రెస్ట్ లేదు. సో వాట్ ఐ డిడ్, ఐ జస్ట్ వెన్ టు ది వి వర్ జస్ట్ బంకింగ్ ది క్లాసెస్ అండ్ ది కల్చరల్ ఫెస్ట్ దట్ వాస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ ఆన్ వెన్ వి వెన్ టు ది గ్రౌండ్. సో ఇనిషియలీ ఐ వాస్ ఫీలింగ్ షై టు ఈవెన్ టాక్ టు గర్ల్స్. ఐ వాస్ నాట్ దట్ పర్సన్ హు టాక్ టు గర్ల్స్ అండ్ ఆల్, but somewhere I had that thing to talk and interact with them and things like that, but I have that initial shy type. And this guy came up to me and showed me the audio stating that this is beatboxing and things like that, an audio. So I was like very surprised how a human can produce all the drum sounds and all. I didn't know the name of what they were doing. I just thought it's mimicry, but he said that beatboxing. I went home and I looked in a YouTube channel and we heard through earphones. I felt it really good because the artist from international artists were really doing great. So I just thought, let me learn this. Me and my friend went back home, researched, and we were able to find a lot of tutorials. So there was this girl from Asia. I don't remember her name. We saw her YouTube channel tutorials. So from there, we started the basic part. And whenever I used to do in front of people or in front of any girl or something like that, they used to get impressed and they themselves come and talk to me. So I like that part. So I really understood that when we do beatboxing and things like that, girls do get impressed. And that's how I started. But I never expect cheyaledu intavarku pothini like entertainment chestini or recognition dortundi. I never got such things. So that's how it started. Accidentally, I got into passion life. I was going as a judge to any events or performing. And the crowd used to love it. No matter any sort of crowd, let it be. Ame crowd undru kuda and entertainment chestanu.
Okay, super. So my journey lo oka one two fascinating experiences emana share cheskogalra, like beatboxers journey in India type lo. Ante ippudu oka talent la recognition raakamundu nunchi meer travel chesi untaru kada. So before that nunchi, when beatboxing was actually recognized in India, so ee journey lo meeku ochina experiences evano one two share cheskogalra on how did you struggle to make this understand to people first that that is a talent?
Okay, I get it. So in Bangalore, the thing what happens is we had a lot of exposure. Here it's already exposed because we had a lot of events or cultural fests that was happening on. So we had a lot of competition going on when it comes to the entire India. we Bangalore was the most produced beatboxes were living, or we can say most beatboxes were formed.
Okay.
So there were a lot of beatboxes being produced, and there were many people, and we had nothing as such or difficulties in giving our showcase on stages, because we are pledged with a lot of cultural fest. We had a lot of opportunities, but the only thing is that to get on the stage or to someone to give us the performance or the time slots to perform was a little difficult, because we have to go and request them to give us a stage initially as a student. But later on, once we reach the place and once we get recognized, things will automatically come to us, and people will contact us through Instagram or ask us to judge the events. And we keep getting opportunities, but the only difficult part that we don't get is reality shows.
Oh, okay.
These reality shows, it's like damn difficult, because they'll ask beatboxing, what are you going to do? If they want dance, they'll conduct a dance show in the competitions. For beatboxing, there is only one reality show, that is India's Got Talent, right?
Okay.
So we have to be really unique and apart from every other beatboxer, only then we can reach up the television part. I'm trying my best, but I don't know when I will reach.
I hope you will be reaching it very soon, because I have seen some shows on the West where it goes like beatbox battles. It's just like a reality show. Just like we have the dancing competitions in India, that's already happening. I think that will come down again to India very soon, where you might be a part of it in future. We never know. That's the reason we need to keep our voices as out as possible on what we're actually doing, and we should make our existence seen in as many platforms as possible, so that we can get an opportunity, something like that, if anything come across. సో తెలుగులో కానీ ఇంకా వేరే రీజన్స్లో మన ఇండియాలో కూడా ఈ బీట్ బాక్స్ బ్యాటిల్స్ షోస్, రియాలిటీ షోస్ అనేవి స్టార్ట్ అవ్వాలని నేను కూడా వెయిట్ చేస్తున్నాను. మీతో పాటే మీరు పార్టిసిపేట్ చేయడానికి వెయిట్ చేస్తుంటే నేను ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ చేయడానికి వెయిట్ చేస్తున్నాను, అంతే తేడా.
ఓకే, బట్ ఐఎమ్ జస్ట్ వెయిటింగ్ ఫర్ ఇట్. ఐ డోంట్ నో, లైక్ హోపింగ్ ఫర్ ద బెస్ట్ ఇన్ 2021, మేబీ trying to give some auditions or something. If there is any opportunities coming across, for sure, no matter whatever work I'm doing, I'll just leave that and I will just go for the shows.
Because recently, Sam Jam episode lo, if you have seen Sam Jam episode, in the first episode, okay, beatbox and tiskochi, they were...
I know that guy, Sudhir, he's my one of my friend. I know him, he's from Bangalore itself.
Okay.
He's a flute beatboxer. The wooden flute with beatboxing. That's what he does.
Yeah, correct. Flute beatboxing, he actually performed in Sam Jam, so... many people know about it now.
Yeah, correct.
నేను కూడా ఫస్ట్ టైం అప్పుడే చూసాను సామ్ జామ్ లో.
ఓకే,
సో మీ టాప్ 2 ఇన్స్పైరింగ్ బీట్ బాక్సర్స్ ఎవరైనా ఉన్నారా టు మేక్ యువర్ క్రాఫ్ట్ బెటర్ ఆర్ యు సీక్ ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ టైప్ లో?
ఐ డోంట్ హావ్ ఎనీవన్ యాజ్ ఆఫ్ నౌ, బికాజ్ ఐ యూజ్డ్ టు క్రియేట్ మై ఓన్ స్టైల్. బట్ ఇనిషియల్ డేస్ ఐ యూజ్డ్ టు ఫాలో దిస్ గై ఫ్రమ్ యునైటెడ్ స్టేట్స్, దట్ ఇస్ నేపామ్. Is also known as Neil Mudios. That's what his real name, I believe, but I'm really not sure. But his name was Napalm. So that guy was a little bit inspiring for me to learn a lot of advanced skill of beatboxing.
Okay, what quality in him made you inspired to look up to him? I mean, he was one of
the world vice champion. So to the entire world, he was the vice champion. Something he was very unique, because there were beatboxing happening on, but it was very old school, just the basics drum kit, but he got the sub. So whenever the DJ plays, there is a sub bass going on, right? So he introduced those sounds, something he created his own style. So that's when I started inspiring him and learned advanced skill. There are evaluation happening, revolution happening in beatboxing. Got it. So, and every new person will invent something or the new sounds. We need to learn that and collaborate with a normal basic part, and we need to cogent with it, and we need to showcase, like, mix basics plus the advanced skills together and make more entertainment skills. That's improve our skill set.
ఓకే సూపర్. సో ఇప్పుడు మీరు ఎలాంటి టైప్ ఆఫ్ మ్యూజిక్ విన్నారు వైల్ యూఆర్ గ్రోయింగ్ అప్, అండ్ హౌ డిడ్ దట్ inform your beatboxing?
So initially, I was a bathroom singer, to be honest. So okay. I used to sing while I taking bath and things like that. I have the music sense. Whatever song you give it to me, I will just listen to it and I can able to produce. I will try. I have done a lot of cover of these songs, probably many album songs and many songs covers I've done. So that's where I understood that I'm morely into musicality stuff, because beatboxing is divided into two parts. One is technical, where they be very fast. The other one is musical, where they go with the music sense and flow structure.
So do you prefer musicality or technicality?
I prefer musicality because I'm very good at it comparatively to technicality.
Okay.
Because musicality is the one which will entertain most of the crowd. So technicality will impress only the set of only beatboxes. Only technicality is mostly used in battlefields. Musicality, we can do it in battles as well as we can entertain the crowd. So it's for both.
Okay, okay. So here we'll take a break and we'll come back.
This is a P2 Media podcast.
మనకి ఈ మధ్య ఆన్లైన్ క్లాసులు వాట్సాప్ ఇన్స్టాల్తోనే రోజు మొత్తం గడిచిపోతుంది. ఏదో కొంచెం టైం దొరికితే సినిమాలు యూట్యూబ్లో. మరీ ఇన్ని చేసుకుంటూ రోజు పేపర్ చదవాలంటే కొంచెం కష్టమే. మరి రోజు పేపర్ చదివే అలవాటు ఉన్న వాళ్ళు కూడా టైం దొరకట్లేదని చదవడమే మానేశారు. పోనీ ఆన్లైన్లో చదువుదామా అంటే పేరాలు పేరాలు చదివే ఓపిక ఎప్పుడో నశించింది. అందుకే మనకి వీలుగా సూటిగా సోది లేకుండా వారానికి ఒక్కసారి ఒక సాంగ్ వినేంత టైంలో న్యూస్ వినేస్తే ఎలా ఉంటుంది? మనలాంటి వారి కోసమే ఈ న్యూస్ కాస్ట్. మన పాతతరంలో రేడియోలాగా ఈ జనరేషన్లో న్యూస్ మొత్తం పాడ్కాస్ట్ రూపంలో ఒకేసారి 5 మినిట్స్లో వింటే ఎలా ఉంటుంది? ఈ వారం మనకు కావాల్సిన హైలైట్ అండ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ న్యూస్ అంతా లేట్ చేయకుండా ఒకసారి వినేద్దాం పదండి. నేను మీ న్యూస్ కాస్ట్ హోస్ట్ వినీషా, మిమ్మల్ని ఎవ్రీ మండే కలుస్తాను.
Hey guys, welcome to the second part of this episode. Hope you love the music. అది నేను ప్లే చేసింది కాదు, మనోడు బీట్ బాక్సింగ్ చేసింది. ఇట్ వాస్ ఫెంటాస్టిక్ క్యారీ.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ బ్రో.
సో కెన్ యూ టెల్ us అబౌట్ మోర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఆన్ యువర్ టెట్ టాక్? అంటే మీరు 7 TED Talks ఇచ్చారు కదా, ఆ టెట్ టాక్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఎలా ఉంది? అండ్ హౌ డిడ్ యూ గెట్ ద ఆపర్చునిటీ టు గివ్ ద టెట్ టాక్? అండ్ వాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ డిడ్ యూ వాంట్ టు కన్వే త్రూ ద టెట్ టాక్స్?
So TED Talks, if I have to say that my very, very TED Talks that has happened was in New Horizon College. It's one of the best colleges in Bangalore and top colleges, engineering colleges in Bangalore. So what happened was they were have invited me to judge the event, but at last minute, they were not able to provide me the judging part. Even I was busy at that time. So what they have done is they have given me the platform, which was after the cultural fest, which was a national level fest that happened. It's called a Sargam. After that, the organizer had given me an opportunity, a platform in TEDx. That was the very first one that has ever happened to me. I just thought TEDx will just be a normal show and things like that. But later when I did a lot of research about it, I got to know it's a very big platform for anybody. Only when you people are famous or recognized, you get the stage to showcase your talent or tell them or tell the audience about how your life journey was. So I just started giving my TED Talks as a performer, because there were two sets. You know, as an artist, he has to give performance and talk. And there were other sets, education. From each and every sector, they used to pick people who are very recognized. And they were given a platform to tell their life journeys. So that's how it kept on going on and on and on. And one of my video got released on the main TEDx, which was Siddhaganga Institute of Management Studies, which is in Tumkur.
Okay.
So over there, me and my friend Pavan had performed together. That video was released on the main TEDx video. And that's how. Then after getting an opportunity and telecasting or getting recognized, so many times. I just want to give away place to other beatboxers who get the opportunity, right? And that's the right thing, because I cannot keep on doing TEDx, right? So that's when I stopped it. So if I'm coming up with something new or something like that, then I will probably give one or two and that's it. I'll end it up.
Super, super. So how was the reception of the High Range Book of World Records when you have got the recognition from them? So how was your reaction and how was your family's reaction and support?
So initially, parents never used to support. Whenever I said I need to go to beatboxing, there was a very difficult times in my life where I have to travel by buses and go to many other places because I've almost traveled all the colleges in Bangalore. So I had to go in buses or travel. It was literally a difficult time, if I have to say, because only if I win the competition, I'll have some money to travel back home. Right?
Yeah, yeah. I would.
So that's what the difficult times that I had, but it's okay. But something we struggle for it, we will have the benefits in future, right? So
yeah.
That's how I started. And yeah, my parents never used to support. They were always cribbing about, you always need to study. That is what you're going to get fetch you full bread and butter.
Yeah.
They were very much cribbing about it. But finally, so I had to clear my backlogs, which I had like 22 subjects, which I have to write, which was like something of, I felt myself like a security guard of the college, coming every day to college, day, afternoon, and the next day. Coming every day and writing two subjects at the same day, that took for 100 marks and all, was like damn stressing out for me. So, but somehow I cleared. But college used to support, but when it comes to academic part, they never supported me because I never used to go to class at all, first of all. I was mostly into, my classroom was the cultural fest.
Okay.
So my classmates were like the audience. My books were the mic, if I have to say. So I used to go to many cultural fests, and that's how I'm like grown up. Then after big struggle cleared, then right now I'm pursuing my MBA.
So when you got the world record, what was the reaction of your parents?
So my parents, they had a little bit trust. First of all, they were very cautious about my graduation part. So they were a little bit happy when they saw. And later on, they were like, you do whatever you want. We really don't care because we have that belief in you that you already have a graduation. If this is not giving you life, it will give. So they're not questioning me right now. Wherever I go, whatever I do, there's no question raised, and they were happy about it. But they never shown to me, but it's okay. But I can make the feel of it.
Okay. So ipudu mee life lo mee journey lo there will be a situation untadi where you have lost hope and edi support cheyaledu, like college support cheyaledu, family support cheyaledu, friends support cheyaledu, they think that you have gone mad choosing this path and trying to do something in this. So aa phase lo what kept you going and how did you keep your mental sanity at that time?
So whenever I'm depressed or whenever I'm in a sad status, so this thing has always kept in my mind. In a week, I should be on the stage. So if I have a schedule for a month, I should at least perform for at least two stages I wanted. If it's not happening, then I will have the stressed out. I'll be very, very stressed out. The entire week will not be good if I don't be on the stage or entertain people, or if I don't hear the crowd noise cheering for me, or is somebody texting me on Instagram saying I was amazing and things like that, right? When I get that appreciation text from unknown people, or whenever I go out, people coming and talking to me and asking me, bro, I've seen you here and there, which this all keeps me happy.
Okay.
Certain thing. So this, if I don't have this, I'll get into depression. If I get back to the stage, it will go off. It is normal. It's like that.
So feedback is the thing that gets you going either.
Correct. Because any artist for that matter, whenever he's doing something, he's doing it. So whenever we come on the online platform, even for you also, people needs to share the art form. They're not going to give anything for it, right? They're just going to get entertained. They're not going to pay anything. If they have to see a real big celebrity, they need to really pay. If they have to see Aharon Rahman performing, they need to pay a lot of money and go. But we as digital creators, what we need to do is we just do it. We don't get anything out of it.
Okay? Exactly.
We just post it for our own satisfaction or for our own passion. We do it, right?
Yeah.
and people need to appreciate it or comment or share. They're not paying us anything for it, but I wish people do it because they have time to share all nonsense stuff on the social medias, right? People like some girl will just wink her eyes and she gets famous over the night and all. That's not at all a talent, first of all.
Yeah.
That's what
so listeners, ఇప్పుడు మీకు ఇప్పుడు మీకు అర్థమేమంటే ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ విచ్ మీన్స్ ఎ లాట్ టు అస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డిజిటల్ క్రియేటర్స్. సో మీ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ అండ్ మీ అప్రిసియేషన్స్ ఇస్ వాట్ గెట్స్ అస్ గోయింగ్ టు డూ మోర్ అండ్ క్రియేట్ మోర్. సో మీ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్స్ మీరు జస్ట్ వింటమే కాకుండా మీ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్స్ మాకు ఇస్తూ ఉంటే ఇట్ విల్ బూస్ట్ అస్ అవర్ ఎనర్జీ టు డూ మోర్ కంటెంట్ అండ్ టు bring more people on this platform. So nana digital artist ni harry lanti digital artist ni mee feedbacks tho koncha fuel up chesthe we'll be coming up with more content to entertain new people. So feedback is really important for us and means a lot for us. So ippudaka meer chaala feedback icharu, it's been like 4000 plays across 24 countries, which is madness to me in 3 months. So ee appreciation ఇట్లానే కొనసాగాలి, ఇంకా ఎక్కువ రావాలి, మీలో చాలా మంది స్టోరీస్ ని నేను వినాలి అని కోరుకుంటున్నాను. ఆన్ దిస్ నోట్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు సే దిస్ టు యు ఆల్, థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ ఆల్ ద సపోర్ట్ అండ్ లవ్ టిల్ డేట్. సో ఐ విష్ మోర్ అప్రిసియేషన్ ఫర్ బోత్ హ్యారీ అండ్ మీ ఫ్రమ్ నౌ ఆన్ 2021. సో హ్యారీ, ఇప్పుడు మీ జర్నీలో వాట్ యు వాంట్ టు అకంప్లిష్ త్రూ దిస్ బీట్ బాక్సింగ్ కెరియర్, అంటే మీ ఫ్యూచర్ అకంప్లిష్మెంట్ గోల్ ఏంటి?
వన్ థింగ్ ఐ హావ్ డిసైడెడ్ I just don't want to tell people that once upon a time I was a beatboxer. Even if I get married, obviously in another like 5-6 years, I don't want to tell people that once upon a time, no such stories like fairy tales. I don't want to do those stuffs.
Okay.
I have my recognitions or whatever the certificates or mementos that I've received. I don't want it to be in museum at my house. It has to be keep on going on and on until I get aged or even if I'm old. I will still keep doing it. Never give up on your talents because it's something which you, with difficulty or accidentally, you would have identified it, right? Just work towards it. At the same time, your career is also important. You need to take care of family as well. You need to have something in life as a backbone, main stuff. But when you find something artistic and which gives you recognition and people are able to recognize, you're just born once, right? So yeah. We need to make sure that people know us. When we die or something, they should always remember us. Oh, he was a person with some identity. I don't like to carry my father's identity. He's so-and-so son and all. So we should have that thing, right? He's individually developed, made by myself, not made by someone else. I don't want anyone's identity. So
I can totally relate and couldn't agree more for what you have just said. And I wish you, and I hope that you'll be continuing doing the same thing you love throughout your life.
Correct. I will do for you.
So, ippudu mee beatboxing community undi kada, what do you see in 5 years of beatboxing community's future in India? Until
so there are people who are taking it as a career without going to a job and all, full time into beatboxing. I hope the organizers or any of the college cultural committee or any people inviting us not to call us for free, because we also have bills to pay and we also need bread and butter to have. It's not that we can always come for free, right?
One
thing, until and unless people appreciate it, or when we do work for them, obviously they need to pay us, right? We cannot do it for free and just sacrifice our own life, something like that. How long can we do it? So people who are taking up this serious beatboxing as their career, they need to be appreciated because literally taking risk in life.
Yeah.
Correct. They're literally taking risk in life. But I'm not, I don't want to take that because I want to have a best life. I mean, a good one. And taking entirely, you know, sometimes we'll have that భయం అంతా చెప్తారు కదా.
ఓకే, సో ఇప్పుడు మీరు చూసిన జర్నీ ఉంది కదా, మీరు చూసిన జర్నీలో ఒక 2-3 టిప్స్, అంటే ఒక 2-3 లెర్నింగ్స్ ఆర్ లెసన్స్ మీకు ముందరే తెలిసి ఉంటే యూ వుడ్ హ్యావ్ ఎ బెటర్ స్టార్ట్ ఇన్ యువర్ కెరియర్ దట్ యూ చోజ్ అండ్ మీకు అనిపించే 1-2 పాయింట్స్ ఏమైనా చెప్పగలరా, సో దట్ ఇట్ కెన్ హెల్ప్ సమ్ వన్ బడ్డింగ్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ about to choose this as a career?
So initially, when you start beatboxing, obviously people will mock at you. What are you doing? What is this? Right? There will be people who will demotivate you. Never listen to all those stuffs. It's not really, doesn't matter. Because at the end of the day, they're not going to live your life or lead your life. Many would demotivate. Why are you doing this? Don't do that. Don't do this. You like it? Just go for it. Any person for that matter. Even for you also, why are you doing, why are you wasting, taking interviews of people and collecting stories? Never do that. Because it's our something wish and it's our passion, which we like to do it. And never listen to or get demotivated on all the stuff. Just keep doing whatever you like. Something or the other will fetch something better in life.
Okay.
And then another thing is never ever give the opportunities that you receive. Always keep going on for all the opportunities that you go through. Always go through all the opportunities that you come across. Utilize the opportunities. And one or the other stages will get you a bigger platform. Every small stage will be a bigger stage one day.
Super. So what do you like the most? Like performing, judging, or training people to do the beatbox? What do you enjoy the most? Don't tell me all three now.
No. I'll choose two. One is judging. Judging, I like it because, I mean, the respect that they give.
Okay.
And second thing is, I love to judge people, first of all. And it helps me improve my judging skills because when a participant is on the stage, I need to judge a stage appearances.
Okay.
So I can judge his mind what he's going to do the next. So it will improve my judging skills. Second thing is performing because nailing my name within the community is only few people will know about me, right? But the world is bigger. There are a lot many people out. So I will love to perform and entertain.
Super. So what COVID have done to you? Because you're an artist. And
COVID has done a lot to me.
Did COVID it affect you or change you? And what avenues did it open for you?
No, COVID has done a lot to me. One is I lost my job. They laid off me, but still I was able to pay my credit card bills and stuff like that. Last month, I lost my job. And getting a job is very easy for me. I get it instantly. And the second thing is judging online. We lose our vibes going to the cultural fest or performing. I lost it because it's almost been a year.
Yeah.
And after 1 year, I'm going to judge in Chennai, one of the beatboxing championships that is happening on in Chennai at Red Hills. The place is some Galaxy Mall. I'm really not sure about the name. Some Galaxy Mall in Red Hills. So okay. After 1 year, all the beatboxers are getting an opportunity to showcase on a bigger platform.
Okay.
And judging online is one of the worst part. I feel so sleepy when I do that.
Okay.
And third thing is, we couldn't expose much. I wasted 1 year of my time. I could have done a lot. In this 1 year, many people would have forgotten me. That's when I got into digital thing. Reels, TikTok. TikTok was going on. I was getting famous doing all this acting and stuff like that. People.
And then it got banned.
Then it gone. Then Reels, I was really uncomfortable doing it. But then this application, Roposo app, it's in one of the Indian made application.
Okay.
Their manager had contacted me and he has given me an opportunity to showcase it online. They used to pay me.
Okay.
So basically based on the views and likes, they used to pay me. So that too, it was payment, Paytm, you know, Paytm payments.
Used to happen.
So I was like, okay, fine. I used to use TikTok because TikTok was developed and it was having a lot many features. So I got an opportunity to showcase my talent in Roposo. They have given me the recognition. So whatever I used to do, Roposo was not developed much when it comes to features, but TikTok has it. So I used to make videos in TikTok and upload it in Roposo and make money.
Okay.
So always use the opportunity that you get from any places, a platform for that matter. It is not necessary that you have to get recognized in one place. Whichever place is giving you the recognition, go in that way and utilize the opportunity that you get or you come across.
Okay. సో హ్యారీ, ఇప్పుడు మీ జర్నీ ఉంది కదా, మీ జర్నీలో వాజ్ దేర్ ఎనీ ఇన్సిడెంట్ ఆర్ ఎనీ కాన్వర్సేషన్ విత్ సమ్వన్ దట్ చేంజ్ ద వే యూ లుక్ ఎట్ లైఫ్ అండ్ ద వే యూ టుక్ దిస్ కెరియర్ పాత్ ఇన్ సమ్ అదర్ డైరెక్షన్?
I never had such things because I used to always, talk to myself. What am I doing? I need to do something different. I'll keep thinking about it. So whenever I'm alone or something, I'll keep thinking about it. I seek for opportunities. I'll be like going on Instagram, looking at it. If I have any previous contact, just to drop in a forward messages, like if there is any event or something like that. Because at the time of New Year, we do approach the event organizers because they are the one who's always into it, right?
Yeah.
We always make sure that we are there because sometimes they would have forgotten us, correct? We would have done one or two events for them. They would have forgotten us. So always build a public relation with them or build a good conversation with them so that they don't forget us and give us always the opportunity to showcase and always always be in touch with the colleges, the committee, cultural committee, so that we always be there because stages are the places where we can expose ourselves.
Okay. So do you want to convey any message or tell something about anything to the listeners out there?
That's what I wanted to say, everybody. So if you're really talented, if you wanted to always think twice, always your family as well as your life as well, your career. So never give up. First thing. There are a lot many demotivators in your place or anywhere surroundings. Just hear it in 1 year and just listen it in 1 year and live it in another year. Only then you'll move forward. If you just listen to them and get demotivated and you'll never go where end up in life. Always grab the opportunity that you come across. It will lead to a place where it has to. Because we will not know where what will happen. All magic happens in one. Over the night, as I said, the wink girl. The girl wings and all.
Yeah.
She becomes like full famous.
Yeah.
TikTok also, many people got the opportunity to be as an actress or actor in serials on any platform for that matter.
Oh no, choose a name, Buddha. So before we wind up, one final segment of beatboxing, I want to just hear it out from you once more. Because it was fantastic while we started the second session of the podcast. So can you just play it out something?
Okay. So you guys would have listened to the song Believer from Imagine Dragons, right?
Yeah.
So I can do the exact sound without any use of instruments through my vocal. So I'm just going to do, since I said I'm a musicality beatboxer, I'm just going to prove myself that I'm really into musicality. And here we go. Your master of a You made me a believer.
Fantastic. Can you try something in Telugu if you can?
I'll just give a try because I need a singer in Telugu because if I've seen my video, there would be always a singer who
singer unte perfection untadani cheppi videos lo chusara, that's the reason I was just checking with you. Yeah,
but I will try my best, but it's not need not be perfect, but I don't know if I'm doing it wrong, apologize me for that.
It's fine, just a casual thing. Boop boop. బాహుబలి సాంగ్ కదా ఇది.
కరెక్ట్, దట్ ఇస్ బాహుబలి థింగ్, రీమిక్స్ ఆఫ్ బాహుబలి. ఐ కెనాట్, ఐ కుడెంట్ డు ఇట్ పర్ఫెక్ట్లీ, బట్ ఐ జస్ట్ డిడ్ ద రీమిక్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్.
యా, బట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ గుడ్, ఇట్ ఇస్ గుడ్ యాక్చువల్లీ. యా,
థ్యాంక్ యూ.
సో థ్యాంక్ యూ హరి, థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ యువర్ టైమ్ ఇన్ యువర్ ఇన్ ద షార్ట్ నోటీస్, అండ్ థ్యాంక్స్ ఫర్ joining in my show, and I hope you have enjoyed the experience of doing the podcast as well.
This is one of the first podcast, and thank you for inviting me as well, Vamshi. It was a very good opportunity that I've given. I hope many would have listened it. My conversation would have changed, I believe, in someone's life, is what I think. If he's an artist or something like that, some of my words would have reached him, and I've been happy for him to succeed in his life because I shared my experience, right? So
yeah, so thank you once again. So hope you achieve all your goals that you're aspiring for. So thank you again.
You're welcome. Thank you so much, Vamshi. Bye-bye.
So that's it, listeners. Next week, malli inko Telugu talent to me mundu vastanu. Until then, this is Vamshi signing off.